I shared a quote by Erich Fromm recently that read, "Paradoxically, the ability to be alone is the condition for the ability to love." And so I thought I'd explain exactly what that means, because being paradoxical as it is, I'm sure that many people find it confusing, and also this is something which really needs to be understood. In order to have a healthy, fulfilling relationship, one must first be able to embrace being alone. Because if you can't embrace being alone, to be totally comfortable with the idea of being alone, then your ability to love genuinely, authentically, freely will likely be inhibited by the desperation not to be alone. And unfortunately, so many people pursue relationships from a sense of loneliness, which is why so many relationships are so unhealthy, why there's so much conflict, and why so many relationships fail, or at least remain in a perpetual state of tension. Unfortunately, much of what we call love has nothing to do with love at all. It has much more to do with fear and insecurity, with desperation and loneliness. So much of what we call love is really some form of attachment or codependency, which leads to all kinds of problems, tension, conflict, and so on. And all of that is coming from our inability to embrace being alone, or in other words, coming from a desperation not to be alone. And when we're coming from that mindset, we're more likely to make poor decisions in regard to relationships, specifically in regard to choosing a partner. In some cases, we may be so desperate not to be alone that we'll get involved with anyone who shows an interest without really considering whether they're actually compatible. And so we may end up with someone who doesn't truly respect or appreciate us, or with someone who is self-absorbed, inconsiderate, and so on. But even when we're a little more selective and we get involved with someone who seems to be a good match, our fear and insecurity can still have a negative impact on the relationship. This is because fear obscures love, it inhibits it. But we don't tend to recognize that because culturally we've been conditioned to mistake fear for love. Fear expresses itself in various ways, sometimes as attachment, possessiveness, jealousy, neediness, and so on, yet we've come to consider these things as expressions of love. But really, they have nothing at all to do with love. They're all coming from fear, and they're all expressions of self-interest. In other words, these are feelings which have no consideration for the other, but only for ourselves. And that's not how love operates. In fact, it's quite the opposite. If we're being needy, for example, that's all about trying to get attention and affection and validation from the other. In other words, it's all about you. And the only real interest we have in the other is in regard to what we can get from them. So essentially, it's a kind of selfishness. You're not really concerned with the other person, you're only concerned with yourself. And that's not love. Love isn't about trying to get anything, it's about giving and sharing freely. But when we're coming from a place of fear and insecurity, all we're concerned with is ourselves. What are we getting? What is the other doing for us? Or what have we gotten from them that we now stand to lose? And why are we so afraid that we might lose the other? Because we're afraid of being alone. We can't stand the idea of having to be alone. So this is what I'm getting at, because as long as that fear is there, it's going to affect the entire relationship, and not in a positive way, not at all. It's going to cause all kinds of problems. When we're operating from that place of fear, everything we do is influenced by that. And so everything we do in relationship is actually selfishly motivated, even if it doesn't appear to be. So we might be doing all kinds of nice things for the other, serving the other, giving affection, giving gifts, and so on. And all of that seems very selfless on the surface, but actually we're doing it in order to get something in return. And this becomes obvious when we don't get what we want, when we become upset because we're doing all of these things for the other, but we don't get the expected result. As soon as you find yourself complaining that you do something for your partner, but that they don't do enough for you in return, step back and take a look at that. Ask yourself, are you doing it out of love, which is unconditional, which is free and selfless? Or are you doing it in order to get something from the other, which is not love, but really some form of business? Because anything that you do with the expectation of getting something in return is business. That's what it means to do business. You give something in order to get something. But love is about giving without seeking anything in return. And in so many relationships, everyone is giving or doing something for the other, not out of sincere love, but in order to get something in return. So it becomes all about business, or it becomes political, which means that we're using all these strategies and mind games to control and manipulate one another in order to get what we want, or to try and secure the relationship to make sure that the other doesn't leave, or whatever the case may be. So again, that has nothing to do with love. It's all selfishly motivated. And that motivation ultimately is rooted in the desperation not to be alone. So this is why it's so important, in order to have a healthy relationship, to have a truly loving relationship, that we first have to embrace being alone and not to depend on anyone in order to feel validated or accepted, to feel loved, or to be happy. And the reality is that no one can actually provide those things for us. No one can make you happy. No one can make you feel loved. No one can make you feel accepted and validated. No one can make you feel secure, not ultimately. Maybe for a little while you might feel that way, but it doesn't last. It doesn't last because it's not coming from you. So this is why so many relationships are problematic. People are always complaining that their partner doesn't make them happy anymore. Well, guess what? It's not their job. Your happiness is no one else's responsibility. And as long as you put that responsibility on someone else, not only is that selfish and unfair, but it's going to lead to disappointment every time. I guarantee it. The reality is that as long as you don't fully accept yourself, you won't ever feel fully accepted by anyone. If you don't genuinely love yourself, you won't feel genuinely loved. And if your happiness depends on others, you'll constantly be disappointed, which means you'll often find yourself deeply unhappy. So this is why it's so important to uncover these things within yourself. This is why it's so important to embrace being alone. The reason we don't like to be alone is because we're so dependent upon others to validate us, to accept us, to make us feel happy and loved. When we're alone, we're faced with our own negative self-judgments, our own lack of self-worth, our sense of inadequacy, and so on. But until we resolve all of that, it will never be resolved, not by anyone. We seem to think that the way to resolve all of that is through someone else. That's why we tend to seek out relationships. We think that someone else is going to make us happy, make us feel loved, make us feel worthy and valuable. But as long as we're relying on someone else to do that, it never gets resolved because no one can actually do that for us. Someone might come along and love us, but if we don't love ourselves, that is, if somewhere deep down we feel unworthy of love, then we won't fully accept the love of another. It'll feel nice for a little while, but then we become suspicious of it. How can this person love someone like me who's unworthy of love. Or because we're so dependent on them to love us, we carry the constant fear that we might lose that love or that person. And our fear not only causes us a great deal of personal suffering, but it will often sabotage the relationship. It's very interesting how that works, how we can actually create the circumstances that we fear. Typically, what happens is that you're in a relationship with someone and you're afraid that you might lose them. And so you start to become more needy. You become overly affectionate in a desperate attempt to receive affection. But to the other person, it feels awkward and uncomfortable because it's not coming from love, but from fear. And the other person can sense that, even if they're not consciously aware of it. Energetically, they can sense your desperation and it feels awkward, it feels uncomfortable, it feels forced and invasive. So the other person, feeling some vague sense of discomfort, will begin to pull away. And when we feel them pulling away, we become more desperate, more needy, more smothering. And that, of course, drives the other person to seek more space. It's just very natural that a person needs a certain amount of personal space, especially when they're being smothered. But we interpret it as if they're losing interest in us, or that perhaps they're beginning to fall out of love with us. And so what do? We become even more frightened, more desperate, more clingy, more needy for attention. And that causes the other person to feel more and more uncomfortable and to seek more and more space. So the more insecure we are, the more desperate we behave, and the more we drive the other person away. And at some point, that fear may turn to paranoia and frustration. The other person, feeling smothered and suffocated, will seek out more time and space to be alone. And we begin to wonder why they're spending so much time away from us, perhaps even avoiding us at times, maybe not answering our calls and so on. And we start to suspect that maybe there's someone else, or maybe they're cheating on us, or maybe they're planning to break up with us. We imagine all kinds of unfortunate scenarios. So we start prying and spying, interrogating, even accusing, just to see if they'll admit to anything. And of course, all of that only causes the other to feel even more uncomfortable around us, which in turn causes them to seek more time and space away from us, where they don't have to deal with our neediness and paranoia. And at some point, we'll have driven them so crazy that they just can't deal with it any longer, and they do actually leave. And what do? We think to ourselves that we were right all along. We had a suspicion that they might leave us one day, and we were right. But what we fail to realize is that we created the very circumstances that led to it. We drove the other person away because of our fear and insecurity. We created the very situation that we were afraid of. So again, this is why it's so important to deal with these things within, independent of anyone else. Whatever fear and insecurity you have, whatever sense of unworthiness, unhappiness, and so on, you have to resolve these things within yourself. That's the only place that you can do it. And once you discover that all of this is available within you already, the capacity to be happy, the capacity to love genuinely and authentically, to accept yourself, to find value in yourself independent of anyone else. Once you face and embrace yourself fully, there's no longer any discomfort in being alone, which means there's no fear of being alone. And when there's no fear of being alone, your love is not compromised by that. This means if you're engaged in any kind of relationship with anyone, you can be more authentic, more genuine, more selfless. You can love more freely, which means giving, not trying to get, and no fear of losing anything, because you're not dependent upon anyone else in order to feel loved or to be happy in someone. And once you've discovered all of that within yourself, no one can take that from you. And so there's no fear of losing anything. And if you can be in a relationship with someone without feeling insecure, without being afraid, without being desperate, you're not going to create all the problems that arise from that. And again, most of the problems in relationship are rooted in some kind of fear and insecurity. So without all that, the relationship is going to be much healthier and much more enjoyable. To be in a relationship without being insecure, there's more ease, more relaxation. It's much more enjoyable for everyone. There's no pressure, no tension, no excessive demands or expectations. And in that kind of relationship, things flow very smoothly and naturally. The irony is that the more freedom there is in a relationship, the more likely the other is going to want to stick around. But the more restrictive, confining, possessive that you are, the more likely you're going to push them away. But to come to that place requires a certain amount of introspection, reflection, observation. I'm not saying that you have to be totally alone in order to fully embrace being alone, although it does make it much easier. So if you're single, then certainly take advantage of that. Use that time to go within and really come to know yourself deeply and to resolve whatever resistance you have to being alone. But if you're currently in a relationship and you want to honor that relationship, then simply become aware of how much of your emotions and behavior is motivated by these underlying fears, and really own it. That means don't make it anyone else's responsibility. Your emotions and behavior are your responsibility and no one else's. So own all of that and begin to examine it. See where it's arising from and work to resolve it. You don't necessarily have to give up being in a relationship to resolve these issues. In fact, relationships can offer us some of the best lessons in life, precisely because they show us the parts of us that need attending to. They show us where we're vulnerable. They expose our wounds. But then it's primarily our responsibility to address those areas. Once we begin to do that, we'll see how our relationships naturally transform, how they become more healthy and fulfilling. As we become more comfortable with being alone, or merely with just the idea or possibility of being alone, we're no longer acting out of fear and desperation. We're no longer compromising who we are, which means that we can be more authentic. And that means that our relationships can be more authentic. We can love more deeply. We can cultivate greater intimacy. We create less drama and conflict, and more easily resolve conflict when it does arise. Your relationships will always be a reflection of your own internal psychology. So if you want to have healthy, fulfilling relationships, you have to become healthy, psychologically speaking. You have to find fulfillment in yourself. You have to discover your own capacity for love and happiness. Then all of that will be reflected naturally in the relationship. Otherwise, if you're full of insecurity and dissatisfaction, self-judgment and unhappiness, a lack of love and worthiness, then every relationship will be a reflection of that. So whatever fear you're carrying, face it, go into it, examine it, come to understand it, and by doing so, you can then release it.
If you find this content valuable, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.